question. I probably should have made this a picture, but now this part is going to be a problem. So anyway, we'll, alright, so we'll use another brush. So you need to tip. It's good to have a lot of brushes. That way you don't have to keep washing them. There's a blue and the red and the yellow gives you an orange. So you can just use that, but I tend to want to use a brown as well. So add a little brown in there. So then the stroke is kind of like two strokes. You form the thing, so one stroke here, another stroke, kind of like that. It's just a little wet, so I think it's going to be a problem. So it's a little wet, so I should dry it off a bit. And then take some more here. And then the last one, maybe over here. And then you use the black, which I have to remember which one this is, the black. This is black here. Then you take the really dark red, dark color, and then you kind of like a fringe kind of thing. And then just a few dabs to give it the leaves. And that's all good enough. And then the last thing is you brown, black, and the blue. Then you do the shadow. Is the other thing, right? So the shadow is done by dragging the brush across like this. So I keep taking different ink. Hold on. So that gives you the shape. So that accentuates the base, right? Your base is white, so having these shadows helps it. And I guess maybe I'll do some red flowers here, then that way kind of semi-form the picture here. So I already have the blue red here. So spread that out. Usually. So it's not advisable to use these dried color typically, but we use it anyway because we are lazy. So 3, 5. So you kind of fill in the gap in these round strokes. Yeah, that's pretty close, and then we have to wait a little bit to put in the black. While we're waiting for that, we can then add some more branches so that I can then connect these. So make it into a picture of some sort. Then you use a light ink to connect these little guys to the So you can touch it to see if it is, how dry it is. So leave this brush very dry, then you can finally we would then fill in all these gaps, the gaps there. Okay, so we got into there, and then we'll define O thing, We put the yellow in the various flowers. So we selectively put some yellow various places. So that's basically it. Use the same kind of stroke to give you this blue here.
Beautiful.
So something like that.
Take a picture. That's the finished picture.
Yeah. Well, that, good. Yeah.